I'm going to talk in this video about a mistake that a lot of learners seem to be making. And if you can avoid this, I think it'll really help you to improve the way that you answer exam questions in preparation for your NEBOSH exam. And what it boils down to is basically being too vague and imprecise when you're writing your answers. I'm going to give you an example, or actually I'll give you a few, and it's centered around certain key words that seem to be popping up time and time again. Equipment. A learner might say in their answer that maintenance needs to take place on equipment as a suggestion for a control measure, but there's actually two sort of words in there that are problematic: maintenance and equipment. I know I picked on maintenance equipment to start with, but now I think about it, maintenance is also another word that crops up all the time. The problem is, it's like, well, what equipment? That's the problem. Then learners don't put down what equipment they are referring to. They're just using the word equipment as, you know, a catch-all term. But there will have been things in the scenario, there will have been equipment mentioned in the scenario that if you include in your answer, so instead of saying equipment, you actually specify exactly what type of equipment you're referring to, that's an example of using information from the scenario to support your answer. This is what NEBOSH want. This is what they write on almost every single exam question, words to the effect of, you must support your answer with information from the scenario. So if you just put equipment without referencing what type of equipment that you're talking about that was included in the scenario, you are not going to get a mark. There might be several items of equipment mentioned in the scenario, and you could pick up maybe 4 or 5 marks because they're likely all to be on the mark scheme, ready and waiting for the examiner to give you the marks that you deserve, but they can't if you just say equipment. Maintenance too is a problem. What type of maintenance? Reactive maintenance? Preventative maintenance? Depending on the scenario, there's opportunities there to really pick up the points by demonstrating that you're applying your knowledge to the scenario that NEBOSH have set. Here are some more examples. Training. Again, this comes up a lot. Training will be used in learners' answers to questions. But what training? What type of training? What do you mean? Induction training, first aid training, training in emergency scenarios, refresher training, certified training, in-house training. There's just so many different types of training. And if you read through the scenario, I bet you any money you'll find all sorts of opportunities to actually be specific about what type of training is needed. And again, there will be marks that the examiner will be able to award you for pointing those out. Another one is information. What type of information are you referring to? Another one is procedures. What procedures are you talking about? Are you talking about a permit to work? Are you talking about a risk assessment? Are you talking about method statements? Again, you've got to be specific and you've got to link it to the scenario. Yet another example would be staff or workers. Again, it's too vague, it's too broad, and it's not specific enough. So instead of saying staff or workers, what you should be doing is specifying what type of workers you're talking about, what type of staff you're talking about. Directors, they're staff too. Managers, line managers, engineers, scientists, maintenance engineers, the list goes on and on. And obviously it will depend on what information is included in the scenario. Probably the classic one here where this mistake is made is PPE. Basically, I never want you to use the word PPE ever again. You might be thinking, well, what shall I do? Write the full word, personal protective equipment, rather than use the abbreviation PPE. No, I don't mean that. I mean it. I want you to take it even further than that and actually stipulate what PPE. Is it a respirator, gas mask, hard hat, you know, neoprene gloves, whatever. But there will be undoubtedly, if you're talking about PPE in your answer, there's obviously something in the scenario that requires PPE, and therefore on the examiner's mark scheme, there will also be probably several things around PPE that you could say, but there won't be on the mark scheme that the examiner uses an opportunity for the examiner to award you a mark just for mentioning PPE. You will have to be, to get the mark, very specific about exactly what PPE you mean for what situation in the scenario, and there you can get your point there because you're using information from the scenario to support your answers. So what I want you to get into the habit of doing when you're practicing exam questions, and you definitely should be practicing answering exam questions, is go through it after you've done your first kind of draft with a critical eye, just looking out for these types of words, you know, the ones that I've just mentioned. Look out for those, identify where you've used them, and then delete them from your answer and replace them with much more specific terminology. Get into that habit, and I really think that you'll find that your performance in answering exam questions accurately will increase dramatically. And it could be the difference between a pass and a fail here. So try that, give me your feedback. Let me know if there are any other words that you can think of that fall into this category of being sort of overused and, you know, too general, non-specific words that just get thrown about that need more specificity to it. Put them in the comments so that everybody else can see them as well. Because I've given you sort of six, but you know, leave some more comments on any other words that you can think of. As always, if you have got your exam coming up soon, very best of luck with it. I'll see you next time.